I don't know. But we'll get into all of that in a minute. But before we go there, speaking of Trevor Lawrence, I don't know if you know this, Paul, but I guess this doesn't really matter for you, but he does have a girlfriend. I'm sorry to everybody watching. And a couple other Clemson players do, too. And Liz has done an extremely hard-hitting piece of journalism this week. It's great investigative reporting. She's telling viewers like you exactly what you need to know. We're going to send it down to her for a breakdown of all the Clemson girlfriends.
Hi, my name is Liz Perna, and today we will be taking the football show in a new direction to discuss something that I think is equally interesting but completely underrated, football girlfriends. As much as Notre Dame is a football school, we are also a legacy school, a marriage school, a ring by spring school. So let's take a quick break from discussing what is sure to be a tense battle this weekend and focus on something that both teams can love, the Clemson football girlfriends. They call themselves the Real Housewives of Death Valley, a friend group of four girls all in relationships with some of the best Clemson football players. First, we have Marissa Mowry, fiance of star quarterback Trevor Lawrence. They are high school sweethearts, and after dating for 6 years, they got engaged this past July. How did he manage to settle down so quickly, you may ask? I don't know, but it probably has something to do with his hair. Next, we have Mackenzie Wilburn, girlfriend of running back Darian Wrencher. One of the team's most inspirational stories, he tore both ACLs in high school, made the Clemson roster as a walk-on, and eventually earned a scholarship in 2018. He also went through a phase of filtering all his Instagram pictures in black and white, but Mackenzie stuck with him through that, which says a lot. The third member of the girl group is Tiffany Jeffcoat, a heptathlete at Liberty University and the girlfriend of defensive end KJ Henry. KJ was ranked number 6 in the nation coming out of high school and is in his third year at Clemson. Can he name all 7 events in the heptathlon? Probably not, but we still love an athletic couple. Finally, we have Mackenzie Grimley, girlfriend of talented tight end Braden Galloway. In the past few months, these two have gone viral with their adorable TikToks and now have huge social media followings. A few months ago, Clemson made Mackenzie delete a TikTok that featured Braden dancing in a dress. Maybe Notre Dame can take advantage of that fragile masculinity this weekend. These girls sit in the family section at home games, vlog their game days, take cute pictures in the stands, and make YouTube videos together. And they're all best friends. Basically, they're living the dream. So, no matter the outcome this weekend, don't stress. When Notre Dame versus Clemson is over, we'll still have the Real Housewives of Death Valley.
Thank you, Liz, for doing the most important journalism been done in these parts.
How much stalking went into that on Instagram?
I don't know. I don't know if Liz can reveal her sources.
Wow,
I don't
what a job.
But this is we've got some good reporters coming on the up and up here at NDTV.
Yeah, no, that was fantastic.
Yeah.
That was well done, Liz.
So we're going to, on the heels of that, we're going to try to do some similarly important journalism here. And we have a series of head-to-head matchups lined up today. So we're going to break down the various position groups and go through and determine which team has the advantage in each group. So we'll go through coaching, receiving, rushing, quarterback, and secondary. So we're going to start it out with coaching, which I would venture to say is the most important part. So Paul, look at this photo right here. In this matchup, who would you say has better style? Brian Kelly or Dabo Sweeney? I mean, look at those fits right there.
I think I have to give it to Dabo. You have to love the Christmas outfit. I mean, Brian Kelly looks sharp there. The shades match the suit real nice, but I'm always a Christmas fan.
Yeah, but look at that sky blue suit and the peace sign, and he's got like some matrix
shades
going on.
No, he's got swagger. Brian Kelly has swagger, but Dabo Sweeney gets the job done there. Yeah. I also think he's a better football coach.
Oh, well, that's neither here nor there, Paul. This is purely what not to wear right now.
And with Santa Claus, I mean, come on now.
I guess a lot
of Christmas on these two shows today.
I know. Well, I mean, Halloween is over, so Christmas season has officially
begun.
That's
true. You can play Christmas music starting now.
Yeah, at least that's what I heard. So I'm going to give this one to BK. You're going to give it to Dabo?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So that is, I guess it's a tie. We don't have Caroline here to break the tie today, but I guess we'll, at the end, if we agree on anything, then we'll give the matchup, the overall head-to-head matchup breakdown to whichever team has more votes at the end.
Okay.
So, second, we're going to go into offensive threat. So for this one, we've got Travis Etienne versus Javon McKinley. Paul, who is the cuter baby, Travis Etienne or Javon McKinley? I mean, look at those faces.
I have to go with Javon. whatever's on Javon's head.
Yeah, what do you
there.
Think? What do you think kind of costume he's
it
wearing?
It looks like he's Winnie the Pooh. He has to be Winnie the Pooh. And
yeah,
the Pooh
he does
one,
have
one
to be. Look at
favorite,
that red shirt.
Probably my favorite Disney character, Winnie the Pooh. So I have to go with Javon.
But look at that smile.
I mean, Travis Etienne looks really happy.
Travis
there.
Looks so. He's thrilled. He's got his Looney Tunes toys in front of him. Look at he looks so excited.
Yeah, no, he looks like a happy guy right there. I can't vote against Winnie the Pooh. I've never done it before.
Is this a topic that's come to the forefront
more often
times?
Than you would think?
Well, I guess we don't really ever know what's going on in Carroll Hall, so that does add up. All right, now we're going to move on to secondary defense. This is a tough matchup, and it's going to be one of the most critical places where the success of this game is going to be determined. So for this one, we've got Kyle Hamilton against Andrew Booth Jr., who has better shoe game? Booth in these green, look at these green sneakers. But Kyle Hamilton has these white Crocs, and if you look closely, you'll see that there is a Tigger gibbet on those Crocs.
Sticking with the Winnie the Pooh 100 Acre Woods theme. Nah, I have to go with the green shoes. The green
what?
Shoes are they're
Paul,
nice.
Where do your loyalties lie? You're three. I guess you
no,
picked
no,
Notre Dame
I picked
on last
Javon,
one, but.
Like Crocs are like a fifth grade thing. Like,
but they're coming
Kyle.
Back into style.
Kyle,
I think.
Grow up, man.
But you get to express yourself via the gibbets. That's kind of
that,
like my.
No, I am a fan of the gibbets, but.
Yeah, okay.
Green shoes, like there. You know, maybe.
Those green shoes are pretty cool. But I don't know. I got to go with Kyle on this one, purely based on the gibbet ratio.
I can understand that. That's not ridiculous.
All right. So where does that take us? I have three Notre Dame. You have.
Two Clemson
and one Notre Dame. Okay, all right. So next.
Fast math.
Yeah, next we're going to move on to receiving threat. This one is an extremely, extremely critical category. We have Michael Mayer, the breakout star tight end, versus Amari Rodgers. So let me just set the scene for you, Paul. You are an any age girl, and you're trying to explain you're trying to explain to your family what the boy you're dating, talking to, have a crush on looks like. And his Instagram, the only post is from 2012, and he's holding a fish. That's option A, or it's from 2020, and he's posing with a tiger. Who do you take in this matchup? Who has the better animal photo, Amari Rodgers or Michael Mayer? Which one of these guys do you want to take home to your mom?
Oh my God!
If you are an any age girl,
I think that Amari Rodgers is the cool guy there, but Michael Mayer, he looks like he has a fun side.
He looks like a bit.
Look
of
at
a
that
dweeb.
Face. He looks fairly happy, and that's an impressive sized fish to catch.
The lake is never bad.
That's the caption.
And hashtag fishing daily.
I like Michael Mayer in this one. He's got his brother, I'm assuming, behind him.
Yeah, look at the
man.
Little lurker in the
I see
back.
See Amari Rodgers. It's a great tiger.
It's hard to say. I feel like watching Tiger King maybe jaded made me a little bit jaded against tigers, so I'm a little bit scared. So I do admire the courage that Amari Rodgers has here, but the tiger has to be tranquilized, whereas the fish, is fresh out of the
wait,
sea.
Wait, you know it's a stuffed tiger.
Paul, where is your sense of your imagination
all right,
here?
That's a live fish. That's a nice job.
Yeah, I know. But yeah, presumably he wrangled this fish with his bare hands. He's so proud of it. Look at that smile. I mean, the lake is never bad, he says. 119 likes on that photo versus 7,000 likes on the tiger photo. But
I don't want to get too far into who I would rather bring home to mom and dad. But to me, I'd probably say Michael.
Michael Mayer, hometown boy. You heard it here first, the words out of Paul Farrington's mouth. So Michael, I don't know if you're single, but I don't know. If Carroll Hall is having like an SYR or something this year, you might get the invite.
Oh, man.
So last, this is going to be a shocking question. I'm sure no one is prepared for this, but I know I've been using a lot of superlatives when describing these other matchups, but this one just far and away has to be the most important one, and it is quarterback. So Paul, who has better hair, Trevor Lawrence or Ian Book?
Oh, better hair is Trevor Lawrence.
What?
Trevor, look at that.
Paul,
Look, look at the mane.
All right, let me just walk you through.
Ian Book has a sharp cut.
Let me just walk you through the nuances of hair care when your hair is longer, it like goes below your ears. You gotta wash it. And you can't wash it every. It's a very, delicate balance. You can only wash it every other day or every couple of days. No, look. It's hard to tell because this ND printing service. You can't see very clearly on these papers in front of us. But Trevor Lawrence's hair is so greasy.
I guess the crowd they're playing to is not. I'm not a part of that. But to me, that's a nice head of hair on Trevor Lawrence. Ian Book has style, but.
I don't know, but Ian's
I'm
got
also
Ian's
not
got
much
the,
of a hair guy, Ian's so I don't really
sharp,
know anything.
Ian's got the sharp edges, though, and the little he's got a little something going on top.
I would say your sense of style is more important than mine. It outweighs mine.
Aw, that might be the nicest thing you've ever said to me.
Yeah, it's the last show.
All right, well, I mean, I guess crying, check the box, I guess. I don't know, laughing and hurling, I guess we still got to get to those. But, all right, so let's count this up. You take Trevor, I take Ian. We both took Javon.
Yes. I believe I was.
You took Andrew. I took Kyle.
3-2.
We both took Michael, and then I took Brian, and you took Dabo.
So Notre Dame wins.
So every position matchup, if you take them all together, Notre Dame is going to win.
The football game.
The football game for sure, because what is more important in football than hair, shoes, style, fishing ability, and appearance as a child? Honestly, I couldn't tell you.